गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ अभिजीत पाटिल फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक मुंबई। वी आर लर्निंग बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स SC19109, विच इज़ द कोड ऑफ बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स। दिस इज़ द सेकेंड वीडियो डिटर्मिनेंट्स पार्ट टू। इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव लर्न हाउ टू इवेल्युएट डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ ऑर्डर 2 by 2 एज वेल एज द ऑर्डर 3 by 3। Now in this video the learning outcomes are you will able to find minors and cofactors of the elements of the determinant. Now let us see the definition of minor and cofactors. Let A is equal to 3 by 3 determinant A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Now the minor of AIZ is defined as the determinant obtained by eliminating the ith row and jth column of A, that is the row and the column that contain the element Aij are omitted. We denote the minor of the element Aij by capital Mij. So here minor is denoted by capital letter M. You can see that suppose I want to find the minor of A11, it is denoted by M11. Now how to find that? You have to omit the row and the column where A11 occurs. So we will omit this first column and the first row, and we will find out the determinant of the remaining elements, that is A22, A23, A32, A33. You can see that here I have written. So the value of this determinant is in usual way we will find out, that is A22, A33 minus product of A32, A23. Okay, see here I have written that. Now Similarly, we can find out the minor of A12. It is denoted by capital M12. So now we will omit the first row and second column. See the suffix 1, 2. So first row and the second column we will omit, and we will find out the determinant of the remaining elements, that is A21, A31, A23, A33. Okay. Then this is a 2 by 2 determinant, and you know how to find the value of the 2 by 2 determinant. That is, you have to multiply these two elements minus the product of these two elements. Okay. So in this way, you can find out the minor of any element. So always remember that finding the minor means you have to omit that particular row and the particular column where the element occurs, and you have to find the determinant of the remaining elements. Now what about the cofactor? See here, cofactor of Aij is equal to -1i + j into minor of Aij, and that is denoted by Cij. In some books it is denoted by capital Aij, so here I have used the capital letter C. Okay, so cofactor of the element Aij is denoted by Cij is equal to -1i + j into Mij. So you have to multiply the minor with -1i + j. Okay, now we have seen the definition of the minor and the cofactor. Now similarly we can find out the same definition we can use in case of this 2 by 2 determinant. Okay, now suppose I want to find the minor of A. So what I will do is I will omit this particular column and this row, and the remaining element gives the minor. So see, the minor of A is D. Suppose I want to find the minor of C, so I will omit this particular row and this column where the C occurs. So the remaining element is B, that is the minor of C. You can see here, see the minor of C is B. So like that, minor of A is D, minor of B is C, minor of C is B, and the minor of D is A. Now let us see this example. Find the minors and cofactors of the elements of the determinant. Now this is a 2 by 2 determinant. So for my convenience, I will equate this with the general form A11, A12, A21, A22, so that I can indicate the position of the element. So 4 is what? The element A21, 7 is A22, like that. Now you know how to find the minors of each element. I want to find the minor of 2. I will omit this particular column and this row, the remaining element will be the minor. Similarly, minor of -3 I want to find. I will omit this column, sorry, this row and this column. So 4 is the minor of -3. Okay. Similarly, I want to find the minor of 4. You have to omit this particular column and this row. So -3 is the minor of 4. Now you want to find the minor of say 1, so omit this column and this row, so the remaining element 2 is the minor of say 1. Okay, so you see here I have written the minors m11, that is the minor of a11, say 1, m12 is 4, m21 is minus 3, m22 is 2. So I got the minors of each element. Now you have to find the cofactors. So c11 is the cofactor of a11, that means c11 is a cofactor of 2. So by definition c11 is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into m11. See here 1 first row first column, so minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into m11. Now what is m11? m11 is 7, and minus 1 raised to 2, that gives me plus 1. Always remember that minus 1 raised to even power gives me plus 1, and minus 1 raised to odd power gives me minus 1. So here minus 1 raised to 2 into 7. So 1 into 7 gives me 7. Now C12 is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into M12 equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into 4. M12 is 4. Minus 1 raised to 3 here we are having. So minus 1 raised to 3 gives me minus 1. So minus 1 into 4 gives me minus 4. Okay. Then C21 is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1 into M21, which is equal to minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1 into minus 3. That minus 1 raised to 3 gives me minus 1. So minus 1 into minus 3 gives me 3. Okay. Now C22 is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2 into M22. So minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. 2 plus 2 means 4. So minus 1 raised to 4 gives me 1. 1 into 2, that will be 2. So I got the cofactors and minors of each elements. Now similarly, you have to find the cofactors and minors of this 3x3 determinant. Again, you have to equate with the general form, that is a11, a12, a13 and so on. So we can easily locate the position of the element. Now how to find the minor of a11? That you know, you have to omit the particular row and the column and row. So this, suppose you have to find the minor of 1, so you have to omit this column and this row, and you have to find the determinant of the remaining elements. So M11 will be the 0, minus 1, 4, 3, that gives you 4. Now how to find C11? C11 is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into M11, that is minus 1 raised to 2 into 4. Now minus 1 raised to 2 gives me 1, 1 into 4 is equal to 4. Similarly, you can find out M12, M12 means minor of this 2, so omit this particular column and this row and find out the determinant of the remaining elements. So that determinant gives me the value of minus 26. Okay, now C12 is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into M12. Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 gives me minus 1 raised to 3, that is minus 1. Minus 1 into minus 26, 26. Okay, so like that you can find out the minors of each element. A13, A21, A22, like that, and you can find out the minors and cofactors. Okay, see here M33 means the minor of A33, so you have to omit this particular column and this row, get this determinant that gives the minor. Then what is C33? That is minus 1 raised to 3 plus 3 into M33, which is equal to minus 1 raised to 3 plus 3 into 4. Minus 1 raised to 6, that is plus 1, plus 1 into 4 is equal to 4. So here in this example, you remember that you have to find the minor of each element and then multiply the minor with minus 1 raised to I plus Z. That gives you the cofactor of the element. Okay. In 2x2 determinants, if you are going to find the minor, you will get the single element. Okay, if you are omitting the particular column and row where the element occurs, you will get the single element. But in 3x3 determinant, if you are omitting particular column and row, you will get the 2x2 determinant. That is the difference. In 2x2 determinant, you will get the single element. But in 3x3 determinant, if you are omitting the column and the row, you will get the 2x2 determinant, that is the minor. And you have to multiply minor with minus 1 raised to I plus J. That gives you the cofactor of that element. Are you getting? So I think you have learned in this video how to find the minor and cofactors. Thank you very much, all of you, and happy learning.